Work to stop suicides at Sydney's notorious Gap has been held up by lack of money. Authorities say they need another $1 million to finish the program.
These days, tourists are not the only ones watching over the Gap. Discreetly placed CCTV cameras monitor activity 24 hours a day, and emergency hotlines are at the ready. They've been installed as part of a master plan, 5 years in the making, aimed at preventing suicide at our worst hotspot.
More people tragically take their lives here at the Gap than anywhere else.
The problem is Woollahra Council ran out of money to complete the work, and it's not confident the new federal government will match a coalition promise to make up the shortfall.
Maybe I should go and ask Mr. Windsor and Mr. Oakeshott.
The mother of Channel 10 presenter Charmaine Dragoon, who took her life in 2007, is among many urging for more work to be done.
This is a good start. It certainly will make a difference and maybe save lives.
Australia's suicide rate is growing at an alarming rate each year. Most Aussies know how to perform CPR to save a life, but few of us would know what to do to help a person with thoughts of ending their life. And yet suicide is now the most likely cause of death for a man aged under 44 or a woman aged up to 34. Australian of the Year Professor Patrick McGorry offers this advice.
To encourage them to actually seek help and actually go with them to someone who can really assess the situation very, very carefully, because it's a life or death situation.
Amber Muir, 10 News.
And if you need help with depression or mental illness, Lifeline can be contacted on 13 1144 or Beyond Blue 1300 22 4636.